So, let me show you how I would go and predict the 40% of employees who didn't respond to our survey. The first thing I would do is I would take our force model that we're going to use and output the model object so I'm able to use it in a new workflow. So I'm going to use an output data tool, go to file browse, and save this off as model or mod obj underscore fm for force model. I can then run this workflow to save off that model object of the forest model. Like I mentioned before, this is just personal preference for me. I'm then going to go to a blank canvas and input that model object, which I'm going to use in a score tool. Before I go ahead and bring in a score tool though, let me bring in another data set, which is my 40% of employees that didn't respond to our survey. It's titled Missing Employees. I'm then going to go to a score tool, bring that in, and load in each of my input datas into each side of the score tool. Then I'm going to bring in a browse tool and run this model. What we're able to see now is for every employee based off of this forest model, what is the predicted probability that they take either a bike to work, they drive to work, or they take a public transportation, bus or train or whatever it might be, to work. What we should do now is turn these predictive probabilities into ones and zeros so we can get an actual count. So how I'm going to do that is I'm going to build a conditional statement saying if bike score was greater than the car and the public transportation, then it should be one and those should be zeros, and vice versa all around. So we have ones and zeros rather than just a predictive probability percentage. With that, then I can aggregate my data up to get the count of how many individuals actually bike, drive, or take public transportation to work. So let's go ahead and bring in a formula tool. I'm going to replace the score bike field by building out a conditional statement. And this conditional statement is going to be if score bike is greater than score car and score bike is greater than score public transportation, then we're going to say it's one, else zero, end if. If I run this, you can see now we have score bikes as ones and zeros, yet we still have our predicted probabilities for the score cars and the score public transportation. So let's go ahead and do the exact same thing for now the other two fields. So if I run this now, what you're able to see in the browse window is we have all ones and zeros. So now what we want to do is we want to sum up all the records or all the values within each of the score car, the score public transportation, and the score bike to then get the total count of individuals who take public transportation, ride their bike, or drive to work. So let's bring in a summarize tool to do this, where I can simply go over my score bike, score car, and score public transportation fields and add sum. What that's going to give me is the sum of the score of the bike, sum of the score of the car, sum of the score of public transportation. And we could rename those if we choose to do so. But what I'm going to do is simply just hit run. Now what we have here are the results that we were expecting. What we have is the mode of transportation for each of the 40% of employees that did not respond to that survey. So it looks like 913 actually drive to work. We have 481 that take public transportation and 141 that bike to work.